Dr. Gray to give us a little bit more insight and frame this conversation for us today before we get started. Dr. Gray?
Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you can hear me okay. I am so thankful and excited to be with everyone today. And I want to thank the Riley Center and all of the other sponsors for inviting us to be part of this talk. I had not planned on giving written remarks. After all, this was supposed to be a more of an interview, a way for people to understand the book, its arguments, and its potential contributions to public and academic discourse. I was excited to share our work with the public. I knew it would be controversial, or would be deemed controversial, but there's nothing new about work on race being deemed controversial. What was new was an advocate article that came out yesterday. According to the article's author, some people, and who those people are remain curiously vague, were upset with this talk. Well, with one notable exception, the vagueness actually coalesced around Louisiana State Representative Ray Garofalo Jr., who claimed that a nebulous constellation of politicians, educators, and citizens were quote unquote concerned with whether or not this talk reflects LSU. LSU, of course, would say that it didn't. But he would also say, quote, he received some questions regarding this series. In particular, what system should be dismantled and why does this system require dismantling, unquote. I would usually refrain from dwelling on the curious lack of reading skills from the accomplished congressman. Racism, dismantling the system is about as clear as one can get about what system should be dismantled and why. But Representative Garofalo's lack of careful attention to detail exposes a critical dimension of the religion of white rage, namely that rage rarely engages rationally, carefully, or deliberately. We argue in the text that white rage is a religious affect, one that is not governed necessarily by reason or cognition, but instead by a set of discursive and mythical structures that have hardened over time. White rage shows itself in everything from the Constitution to Make America Great Again claims, from NFL protests against Kaepernick's protest to the figuration of angry white women, both in TV and on political commentaries. It shows itself in both liberal and conservative garb, we argue. White rage pays no attention to allegiance to party or partisanship. We say much of this, albeit in a more detailed fashion, in the introduction, which is available on the website for the book. And yet it seems that those who are concerned have yet to take the time to look through the pages, to skim the text and make sense of our claims. Perhaps this lack of consideration was an oversight on Representative Garofalo's part and his constituents and colleagues. I'm sure there are members of the public who are upset with this talk. As the videos show, white supremacy has been rampant and blatant under the previous administration. But no matter the circumstances, the more pertinent question for me is, why would there be concerns about a talk about anti-Blackness and racism? Garofalo implies that this talk Garofalo implies that this talk impugns conservatives, so maybe that's the reason. Maybe conservatism, away from being a financial and economic and political policy, is just a euphemism for white supremacy and its affective variant, white rage.